elderly woman on the bus falls asleep on my shoulder. No adjectives in the wind. Her whistles asleep are choppy. Her lungs, I assume, were embroidered with a thread of screams. Grainy and great. Her phone ringing wakes her up. Her waking up awakens me. Makes me aware of my pocketed indulgence. Alert, she asks me where we are. Right before the checkpoint, I say. She responds, thank you. May God protect you from the evil that comes from the Jews and the evil that comes from the Muslims. Through her thin white shawl, I see the separation and annexation wall. The wall exiles her livelihood of selling figs behind an hour or a 2 hour something bus ride. Travel permits, searching and questioning and being tessellated behind bars into other brown bodies. Waiting. Elderly woman on the bus gets up. Her two plastic bags are filled with 70 mountains and a river. I offer a helping hand. She is concerned about my spine. Women like her have spined me. I insist, let me help you, please. She wants to carry 35 mountains. I told her I got both the bags. Not as heavy as they seem, not as heavy as she's lived. We exit the bus, walking towards the military checkpoint. Under occupation, walking feels barefoot. Under oppression, walking feels like attempting to run in water. The soldier, blonde and sunburned, asked her for her permit. My permit, these wrinkles, older than your country's existence. My smile is a sun. I know this vocabulary is foreign to the rifles of this nation of rifles, foreign to apartheid and separation walls. And, although romantic and armless, knowing the truth feels like the anticipation of a postponed victory. The soldier, accented and un-Hebrew, asks her what's in the bag. Figs, bitch. What else you wanna know? I stuffed them with storms and radical discourse, and I got married at 16, so I know about healing more than you do. I read a couple of books too, and I can demystify me by criming you. My smile, a gloat. I know she had a gun someday, hidden in a wheat bag, and I know she had freedom fighters in her closet. Warrior woman, Zata Diva, she may have hid in her closet too. Elderly woman and I passed the checkpoint. Violent vowels in the wind. Her back hunched, her spine spined me. She takes the bags from my hands. Thank you, she says. My daughter's waiting to pick me up. May God protect you and the youth around you. And before my breath takes a seat, she walks away as if she once knew. Purple shrouds.